Action.
Okay, fantastic. So, where are we? This presentation is all about one thing. Pick your best subjects. Pick the things that you're best at. Because we're now at that stage of, I know people, to you and to your parents as well, this is the business end. This is where it gets serious. We are now, whether we can talk all day and all night whether we think the exam process is fair. We can talk all day and all night if we think that the way we apply to colleges or apply for apprenticeships or even apply to universities is fair and equitable. We can talk all day and all night about it. But the story is, we're out there in a competitive market and I need to make sure that you are best placed to get to where you want to be. Is that an apprenticeship? What do I need to do? What qualifications do I need to open up to you to make sure that you get that apprenticeship? What do I need to do to make sure that you've got the qualifications that get you to the front of the queue for the University of Stirling? What do I need to do to make sure that Forth Valley College or the City of Glasgow College make sure that they don't overlook your application? That's my job now. And the best bit of advice I can give you is pick your five best subjects. For those of you who are going from S4 into S5, an awful lot will come down to what you achieve in that 1 year. What are you able to do in the space of a year? Because the colleges and the universities will judge you on that. So my advice is going to be, pick your five best subjects. For parents, I need to urge us all, and again, even for young people who are going into S6, traditionally, what we would do as parents or as young people when we were, a long time ago, I had a full head of hair, I looked like a young Chesney Hawks, believe it or not, that is certainly one for the over 40s in the room. We were expected to sit maths in fifth year. Well, can I just say, if maths isn't your subject, why would I advise you to take maths in fifth year? If you wish to sit hires, pick your five best subjects. Pick the ones that you're good at and that you will achieve. And if you need National 5 Maths or National 5 Applications of Maths, we will dedicate time for you in S6 to achieve that. But you will be judged on that first sitting. And if it's five hires you need or four hires you need, let's get them. Now that might sound a wee bit serious and a wee bit straight to the point, but that's the message. I need you at the front of the queue. I will not be content, and our young people have heard this message time and time again, I will not be content if you lose a place to somebody from Dunblane or St Modens or Wallace High School because I've not given you the best advice and steered you into the most appropriate course. So let's think about that. Let's think about picking our five best subjects. Now, the process, we're well into the process now, started with the pupil assembly led by Mr. Forrester. We've had our parents' meeting, our information sessions just now. We've had numerous straw polls as we try and perfect the options forum. And it's not quite there yet, we're still making some tweaks and some changes. Our young people are feeding back to us that they need this or they need that to call them. We're doing everything we can to make sure that that happens. But we don't have a final form for you tonight. We will start our interviews on the 16th, which is Wednesday. And by that point, it will be finalised. I'm just looking to this man here who's nodding away because it's his job to make sure that that's finalised. We will make changes right up to the last minute to best suit as many young people as we can. I promise you that. We will do our very, very best to make sure that everybody gets to do what they want. Is that all? Is that a perfect system? No, it's not. Is it guaranteed every time? I'm afraid not. But you need to know and trust that we will do everything in our power. If you put something down, we will do our very, very best to make sure that that's on your timetable for next year. And if it's not, we will look to see where else that can be offered. What else can we do for you? I promise you that. Final options form will be on Wednesday, and then you will sit down with me, or Mrs. Brown, or Mr. Forrester, or Mr. McDowell, and we will go through the options interview with you. Now, by that point, you will have had all the information you need from your teachers, from your faculty PTs. You will have the chance to speak to Forth Valley College, University of Stirling, and then we will sit down and look at a number of things, not just your option choices, tracking report, we will look about where you want to be. So any young person in S5 moving into S6 next year, that options interview is going to be very important. What are you going to be applying for in the autumn? What UCAS application, what's your UCAS application going to look like? Because we need to make sure that you're putting the right subjects into your timetable for next year to make sure that you get those conditional and unconditional offers. Okay, so that's where we are, and that'll be starting this week. The draft option form is out there. As I say, there may be some slight changes to where we're at just now. Mr. Forrest is working very hard to make sure that we try and perfect that as best we can. For anybody from S4 who's maybe not familiar moving into S5, there is the college option on a Tuesday and a Thursday afternoon, and that is in our e-column that you'll be able to see that on your options form. And what I will do is, following this meeting, I will post the links to this and to our online option booklet and a number of other links as well that you may find useful, and hopefully that will give you an idea of what the colleges can offer. A number of our S6, current S6 pupils go out to college on a Tuesday and Thursday as well, so that's not just a closed shop to our new S5 pupils. What we try to do is surround you this time with enough support and advice. I'm not an expert on many things, trust me. So I need to make sure that we've got the best partners in the building to best advise your decision making. We hope that you took an awful lot out of the parents' meetings, the recent ones. And I know they're only 5 minutes, and I know they're short and sharp, but I hope you got a really clear understanding of where our young people are in their studies. The national statistics and pathways I'll come on to in a wee second. It's something that you might find interesting as parents, and it's maybe something our young people might want to tap into when we're having those discussions commencing on Wednesday, about if you pick this, what's the reality? And I'll come back to that in a wee second. As I said, our online options booklet is on the website. I will send out the link to that, because an awful lot of information is still very valid and relevant despite lockdown coming and going. And of course, Forth Valley College are outside with the University of Stirling. And we also have active schools with us tonight because of the number of careers that our young people tap into, part-time and full-time, within the sports sector in Clink Manager. Our careers coaches from Skills Development Scotland are here as well. Many of you are familiar, you'll have met with them already this year to discuss what you're going to do and what pathways you're looking to follow. And then, of course, the people that you see day in, day out, probably the most important people in this whole process, the guidance team. Your head of house will take you through your UCAS application, your college application. They'll take you through your application for any foundation apprenticeships, any modern apprenticeships, and of course, any job interviews that you may have, they will be preparing for them. They are key partners in this journey that you are now on. And then the people who know. You're all going to be new 5th and 6th year very, very shortly. Please go out and speak to the teachers that you see day in, day out, and ask them the hard questions. Ask them what you're going to be studying. Ask them what their expectations of you are. If I sit higher X, what do you expect from me? Do you think I can do it? Ask them the honest question, because they'll give you a very, very honest answer. Okay? And you don't hesitate. Because they're there for that. Don't feel as if you're going to hurt their feelings if you say you don't want to take their subject. Don't feel as if you're going to hurt their subject. Hurt their feelings if you ask them a hard question. Go and ask the hard question. Oh, well, Missy Brown. Come on, quicker. Come on.
Sorry.
Oh, Missy Brown. You ruined it. Sorry. So we talked about the progression statistics. In our online options booklet, at the back, this is one of those things that scares me a wee bit as a parent, because I'm always an optimist and I don't do statistics very well. I like to prove statistics wrong. I like to be that wee bump in the road that goes against statistics, but they often don't lie. And what we'll be doing is we'll be sitting down with you this week, looking at your subject choices, looking at what you're likely to achieve at National 5 if you're currently in S4, or what you're likely to achieve at high. higher on National 5 if you're in the S5. And this is the stark reality. So if you achieve an A, B, C, D in National 5, what's the realistic chance of you passing at A at higher, B at higher, C at higher? And we'll do that with your subjects. We'll look at it very, very honestly. So if you do get, or you're likely to get a C at National 5, we'll have the honest conversation. What's the likelihood of you achieving higher next year? And we'll talk about it. And it's not to say that we'll use these statistics to say, no, you can't sit it, because I would not do that. I never would. But again, it's just about having that honest conversation to make sure that we're making the right subject choices for you. Again, it's just a similar table. National 5, A, B, C, D, the chances of you passing. So there's geography, German, graphic communications, just a wee extract. If you passed, what are the chances of you getting an ATC at higher? Okay, so we'll have that conversation in our interviews. I'll come on to that in a wee second. I hope you've always found me to be honest, and we will continue to be honest. And that's why we don't come in here and promise you the world. You know, we're not going to say that everything that you want to sit, you'll be able to sit. But we will do our very, very best. And if there are any real things that are causing you anxiety or concerns, please come and speak to me. Come and speak to Mr. Forrester, Mrs. Brown, or Mr. McDowell. You know, go through the option choices, but you know that you need to have a particular qualification or you need a particular time set, say, just come and speak to us. Okay? And whilst we will do our very, very best to make sure that you are able to follow the pathway that you want to follow. What we have up here just now, Miss O'Hara will be around. I think she'll be at the doors. She'll be handing out a small booklet to help us with our work experience that will be going ahead in June to highlight the opportunities that are there for you. But importantly, she'll give you a small slip of paper. This is our new page on our website. It's about revision and exam support there. And it's about all the fantastic resources that we have, but also not just academic, but about the well-being process of studying and anxieties and managing anxieties and being nervous and being fearful of exams. There's an awful lot of very, very good advice on there as well. So Miss O'Hara will give you that, and I will send out a letter tomorrow, very early tomorrow, with the links to everything that we've shown you tonight. So that's me. Mr. Forrester will be absolutely delighted, because I've not promised anybody in the world. I think I promised the S2 parents that you pick whatever you like, you can do it. And then I get a wee bit nervous, so I've promised them that I wouldn't say that to you. What I would say is, can I say it a wee bit?
I don't know what you're going to say, so...
We pride ourselves on going that extra mile, because my main job is to make sure that every young person in here gets to where they want to go to. So to do that, we need to be a school that's for our young people. I've worked in lots of schools that were there for the teachers. I've worked in lots of schools that were there because I've got three chemistry teachers, so we've got three chemistry classes. Doesn't matter if anybody wanted to do chemistry, you just got it because that's how many teachers we've got. I don't like that. Our school needs to be for the young people, the 930 young people who come in here each and every day and work hard. The school is for them. Their school family is there for them. And that's why I challenge Mr. Forrester every single year to satisfy every single options request. Now, we can't do it. It's virtually impossible. It is impossible, because you are never, ever going to satisfy everybody. But what I promise we will do, and we will not stop doing, is that we will go against the trend of other schools. I know there are schools and authorities not a million miles away from here, but unless they've got 10 young people in a class, they won't run it. So you can imagine if you need an advanced higher in A or a higher in B and you go to pick it, because there are less than 10 people there, they just don't run it. We will not do that. Now, I'm not saying we're going to run higher classes with one and two people in them. I can't promise you that. But we will continue to run smaller classes, because if you need it, we will absolutely do our damnedest to make sure you get access to that class. And that causes him an awful lot of stress, and it causes him an awful lot of anxiety. But that's why we're a school for our young people and not a school for our timetable or a school for our staff. It's for you, and we'll continue to do that, and we'll work very, very hard to make sure that everything you want to do is there for you. Okay? I'm going to let you go and speak to the real deal next door. If there are any questions for me or anything that you want to ask just now, I'm more than happy to take any questions, as long as they're easy. No? Can I get away with that? Got away with that? Fantastic. Folks, thank you very much for coming in. Can I just ask you then just to head out into the hub and please go and ask lots and lots of questions.